Okay, so we shall start the class. We were in so we were in go to statement. So I think you people have copied this go to syntax three forms. Okay, so now we will see the program of go to program to print numbers from 1 to n using go to statement. Okay, so just look at this program. Okay, here what we do, we use the go to keyword. Okay, in this program, so the program is we have already discussed in while loop and do while and for loop, that is to print numbers from 1 to n. But here I am using if condition plus go to keyword. Okay, so you look at this program, in the declaration part I have taken I is equals to 1 and the variable n. So in the printf, enter the value of n. Okay, so in the scanf, that is n variable we are using to input the value of n. So the same message, the numbers from 1 to percent d, percent d here stands for the n value. R, now this is nothing but a go to statement. Okay, so where we are using, you look at this tracing part, will come to know, so I will explain that. Okay, okay, so you look at this program. So first I will explain here only like a tracing part, how it works on that. So you can execute in your PC or laptop, so wherever it is comfortable. So you look at the program, after the printf statement, that is the numbers from 1 to percent dr, after that statement, so next 1 2 3 4 four statements are related to go to statement. Okay, so the meaning of go to, so in English also we know the meaning of go to. Okay, if I say go to home or go to college, okay, the meaning is, so we have to do the work. Okay, here also if we tell for the program control to go to, see after the go to, in English also after the go to we have to specify one place. Okay, simply if I say go to, then the next question will be where. Okay, so similarly here also, in case of programming language, after the word go to we have to mention the place where the program control should go. Okay, you look at the program and you come to the go to word. Okay, here it is there. After go to you have to leave one blank space because that is a keyword. Okay, so immediately after keyword either blank space will be there or some symbol will be there in that way. Okay, so that we have to differentiate between keywords and identifiers. Okay, so in case of if keyword above line, after if there is a parenthesis. Okay, that is a separation. So if we can say if is a keyword. So after go to one blank space, you have to leave. After the blank space, see one word I have written. That is nothing but an identifier. Okay. I hope you people remember the rules of identifiers so that you can write down your own identifiers. Okay. In declaration part also, I and N are identifiers plus variables. But in case of go to loop, so here loop is only identifier. It is not a variable. Okay. So identifier which has a value is called variable. So in this program, if you call I and N are identifiers, both contains values. I is equals to 1 and N. User will input a value for n. So both are variables. Whereas loop is only an identifier. It is not a variable because it doesn't contain any value. Okay. So after go to word, you have to write identifier. So what happens is program control will execute from first line of the program till the word go to normally. Okay, without any problem. Okay, it executes normally one after the other. When comes to go to, what happens? See, in front of go to, whatever the identifier is there, that is nothing but the, we can call it as place where the program control should go. So look at the arrow mark from go to word to loop word. So I have drawn arrow mark. So program control will move again backwards from go to word to loop word. So from loop, after loop word, whatever the statements are present, printf, I++, if I less than or equals to n, these three statements are executed again. So first time it has executed, but because of go to, the program control has moved to the word loop. After loop, you have to give colon. So after the colon, whatever the statements you write, so it executes one by one in sequence. Printf I plus plus and if I less than or equals to n. After if I less than or equals to n, if that condition is true, again go to loop. So this process continues. So I have taken the identifier name as loop just to understand better. So here it is acting like a loop. Going to the loop statement, coming back to go to statement. Going to the loop statement, coming back to the go to statement. So now, because of the condition, the go to statement is not working. Go to statement is working as usual from the definition itself. That is, program control transfers from one part of the program to another part unconditionally. Why we have written condition is to break the loop. Otherwise, these three lines will execute infinite number of times and program will not terminate at all. Okay. So you look at the tracing part. So n is equals to, I have taken n is equals to 5. We can take n value as anything. Okay, after n is equals to 5, I have taken I is equals to 1. So when comes to the loop statement, loop colon printf. So print percent d backslash d i. So in the tracing I have written print i. So 1 is printed. Okay, after print statement I plus plus is there. So I value is increased by 1 and it becomes 2. After I is equals to 2, you look at the program, condition is there. If I less than or equals to n, if I less than or equals to n, substitute the value of I and n. So I value is 2, n value is 5. So 2 less than or equals to 5, yes, it is true. So you look at the program, I have put the arrow mark for if condition, that is wherever it is true. So if it is true, program control will move to the go to loop. So when program control comes to go to loop, where it has to go? It has go back to the statement where loop word is there. So look at the arrow mark here. So when it comes to the statement where loop word is there, again you have to execute these three statements. That is printf I plus plus and if I less than or equals to n. So look at the second round of tracing. Okay, loop statement is there. Print I. So one is already printed. Now it prints two because I value is increased by 1 because of I plus plus. Okay. Again I plus plus is there. So I value is increased by 1. So I becomes 3. Okay. Again check the condition. If I less than or equals to n, 3 less than or equals to 5, condition is true. Go to loop. Okay. So this process continues for first, second, third, four rounds it continues. Okay. When I value becomes 6, you observe the last round. When I value becomes 6, there what happens in case of condition, if I less than or equals to n, 6 less than or equals to 5, condition is false. So in case of while loop, do while loop, for loop also, if we have taken n value as 5, the same situation we have come across. But there while loop, that is while keyword, do while keyword and for keyword, here I have taken if keyword. Okay. Here you should not call if as looping statement, if is a conditional statement only. Because of go to statement, it is acting like a loop. These four lines are acting like a loop. Okay. Once I value becomes 6, 6 less than or equals to 5, false. Is 6 less than or equals to 5? No. So condition is false. If the condition is false, the statement present immediately after that condition will not be executed according to if statement rule. Okay. So which is the statement immediately present after if condition? Go to statement. Okay. That go to statement is not executed. That is go to loop. This statement is skipped. That means it is not executed. So if this statement is not executed, then the program control will move to the getch function. Okay. That means if go to loop is not executed, means the program control will not move back to the loop statement. So this looping process stop. Okay. You look at the tracing part. F I have written. F indicates false. If the condition is false, the program control will come to the getch. After getch, closing brace is there. Program is ended. So in this way, from go to statement, we have printed 1 to n numbers. Using go to, you can do any application. Just this is one of the example I have given. Okay. Now you can copy this program and tracing with output. Okay, I think you people have copied. So let us execute in editor because there are three forms in GoTo. For all the three forms, I have written program. So at least one program we will see how it works. Okay, so that we will get an idea how program control will move back to the code. Okay. Okay, so this is the go-to of first form. So we have three forms, right? So first form, we will look at this program. Okay, just a minute. Okay, fine. So first I will execute total program at a time. See here, n value, if I give 10, so it prints from 1 to 10. See here, I have not used while loop, do while loop or for loop. So just by go to, we have achieved this output and if condition. Okay, so 1 to 10 it is printed. Now let us try with line by line tracing by taking n value as 5. Okay, so program starts from main declaration statement, then clear screen. It prints the message, enter the value of n on the console screen. Okay, scanf, so that is user should give the input value for n. Okay, so now let us take 5. So here the next message, it will print on the console the numbers from 1 to percent d. So here percent d will be replaced by n value, that is 5. The numbers from 1 to 5 are next. So here you can check two values, that is n value, so n value is 5, and next, so I value is 1. Okay, so in the printf, it prints the value of I, that is 1. Okay, next. Oh, sorry. So next I value, we can check it. So still it is 1. After I plus plus, the value changes. So I value is 2 now. It will check for the condition 2 less than or equals to n. So as we know, the n value is 5. So 2 less than or equals to 5 is true. So go to loop again. The program control will move to the statement where loop identifier is there. So I value is 2, it prints the value. So I plus plus, it increases the value. So now I value is 3. 3 less than or equals to 5 is true. So go to loop again. Program control will move back to the loop. Okay, the statement where loop identifier is there. Okay, so it prints the value of 5. So I plus plus, so I value is 4. Go to loop again because 4 less than or equals to 5 is true. So here again it prints the value of I plus plus, I value will be increased by 1, that is 5. 5 less than or equals to 5 is true. So go to loop. The program control will move to the loop. Okay, it prints the value of I. So I plus plus, I value will change to 6 now. So 6 less than or equals to 5 is false. So if 6 less than or equals to 5, the condition is false, go to loop statement is not executed because the statement immediately following the condition will not execute when the condition becomes false in case of if statement. So that particular statement is skipped. If that particular statement is skipped, the program control should go to get ch. Okay, so after get ch, closing brace, so it will end. So the numbers are from 1 to 5 are 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, I hope you people have understood this program. So let us move to the further program. So this is the program with second form. So here for this program, I have not written tracing because I hope you people have understood the tracing of GoTo with the first form. So that here what we can do is like just understand the program. Okay. Okay. So look at the program. For second form, I have written. So second form is like, see, first we have to write go to keyword, then the label identifier. Immediately after that statement, so we can write the whatever the loop concept we have written, that one. So here it doesn't become loop because after the execution of statement 1, statement up to n, again the program control will not come to the statement where label is there. Okay, it will move further. So that means these statements are executed only once here. As in the case of previous program, it will not execute like a loop. Once it will be executed. So you look at the program here. Same thing. Enter the value of n. We will give the input value as n. The numbers from 1 to percent %d. That is numbers from 1 to n. So here n we have taken it as 5. So here I will change it to 5. So see here loop colon printf. So here sorry. Okay, here. So loop colon, sorry, go to loop. So go to loop means where loop identifier is there immediately after go to statement. You look at the program, immediately after go to statement it is present. So it will come to this statement, this particular statement. Okay, so one time it will print, that is I value will be printed 1. After that I plus plus is there. So I plus plus means it is true. Okay, sorry, it will increase by 1. So I value will become 2. Okay, so once I value becomes 2, 2 less than or equals to n. So here only I will write it if you want, so that you will come to know. So I becomes 2 here. Okay, then here it will check the condition, that is 2 less than or equals to n. So n value here we have taken it as 10. It's okay, whatever it is. So 10. So 2 less than or equals to 10. Yes, the condition is true. But after if condition, I have not written go to loop. So because of that, the program control will not move back to the loop. Okay, it will move further. So 2 less than or equals to 10, condition is true. So which statement is present after if condition? Get CH statement is present after if condition. So because of this statement, it will move further. Program control will not move back to the loop. So this concept you have to understand. Because go to loop I have written, after that loop, printf I plus plus if I less than equals to n. If I have written go to loop statement after the condition, then it will move back. So like in the case of previous program, after the condition I have written go to loop. But in this program, after the condition I have not written go to loop. Okay, so the program control will move further, program will end. So only the value 1 is printed. Okay, I hope you people have understood. So this is in case of second form. Okay, you can copy this program.
Can you please go to the first explanation that you demonstrated, not the explanation, regarding the statements, form 1, 2, 3.
Okay, forms 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, you had that label and
yes, data. Yes.
And you said that it will directly go to the next logical loop. I just want to compare between this and that. So
fine. Okay.
Now, once they copy, I don't want to interrupt them.
Okay, fine. Let them copy.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Can I see the first form?
Okay. Just 2 minutes. Wait. Let all of them copy.
Okay. So okay. Okay.
Yeah.